Alright, take two. There we go.
We on?
Yep.
We're live?
Yep.
We've been having some little problems here, but the gentleman on the camera knows how to solve all those problems. It's Chase Rosade, Rosade Bonsai. We're in New Hope, Pennsylvania in the United States. Welcome to our little demo here. And it's really a landmark day. Today is the third anniversary of the Black Scissors Group. Who's in Black Scissors? Just everybody and anybody. We keep, what do I want to say? Some of the things that are just not up to snuff out of the group. Everybody should be friendly with everybody else, and what can I say? It is the third anniversary. You see the t-shirt that I have on, it's from one of the first Black Scissors get-togethers. What I'm going to do today is that the plant I have is actually a Chinese juniper. It's Juniper chinensis, and the one that is called Etikawa. It's grown from a cutting, planted in the landscape. It was not to be grown as it looks here. What happened is our friendly local neighborhood deer started munching on it over the past 8 or 10 years. Have not left it grow, and I just maybe was a little too lazy of thinking about getting in here and doing something about it. So we're going to develop this and find out. It has a number of trunks, and my feeling is that what style should it be? Since it has many multi-trunks, nice trunks in here, that it could become what some people refer to as a turtleback. All the growth coming off of one common trunk, where a clump style, you can get in there and you can take a tree and you can put 3 trees, 5 trees, 7 trees, 9 trees together to form a clump. These are all coming off of one common root system. In here, if you look closely, you may see a little bit of rootage in here, and that will all be cleaned out ultimately, I don't think today. A lot of these long excessive branches here will be removed, and I will start removing them. Getting an array of tools, just for those who don't know, I'm sitting in front of our studio. It's a cement block building, it used to be for horses, and now it's for bonsai. I'm not going to cut anything terribly short, or I am going to cut things short. I'm going to develop this, and I'm going to get you to look through it, and I'm calling this my front, right in there. Right in there is the front. Excessive branches. If I cut things that are a little bit long, something that I want to develop as a little bit of dead wood on here. I'm not going to have a tremendous amount of dead wood now, but I want to work towards that. Again, this is the front. As far as branches go, as far as this is our major trunk back in here, hiked up about here, so things have to be reduced. So this is the trunk here, this is the trunk here, so we have 1, 2, 3 secondary trunks, a little bit of a branch back in here that I want to fill, use in, as a filler inner. I don't like that big open space in there, although there will be some branches coming down and coming across. Not being live, but I'm not sure we can answer questions for people, but the back is coming out quite far, and this will all be shortened to pull the design of the tree in, so it's not necessarily flat on the front, and we don't have the projection of all of the branches going towards the rear. This is just a preliminary, and when I say a preliminary, it's going to take a number of years for the tree to fill in, the tree to get fine wired, to the tree to have the branch structure where you want it. Bit tougher to get on here is than I thought it was going to be. call that a character of age. For those that know me, I have become somewhat ancient. I've had a lot of fun here doing these things. Okay, again, you see I'm reducing some of the growth down here at the base. I've got a long, long branch coming out here. I even thought at the beginning maybe what I could do is develop it as a tree and as a raft style, using this as my major tree here, and then taking these and burying this in a container and bringing up some of these small side branches to develop trees. Decided against that. I always like to say there's more than one way to skin a cat or whatever the tree is going to do for us. I'm going to take this off. I'm looking at it. Where do I want to go? So I'm going to take this back branch off right in here, because what I want to do ultimately, as I said, I want to develop dead wood on the tree.
Pedro J. Morales says hi from Puerto Rico.
Pedro Morales says hello. Hello, Pedro. And I gather he's weathered the storm. That's a very difficult thing. I'm sure Pedro is going to have to really spend a lot of time cleaning up, doing some of the things that have to be done after a storm such as this. We're going to be lucky in Pennsylvania. I don't think we're going to have... We may get some rain. For those of you that know my wife, Soli, she was in Miami last week and drove north with a granddaughter, a daughter, cats and dogs. And she's now hunkered down somewhere in Washington or Northern Virginia. Okay, looking at the tree, you can see how we've eliminated a lot of the growth to the back here. I'm going to take this other branch off in here. Now, as I said, I will take these branches, I'll clean them up, cut the bark off of them, decide where I want to go as far as the gins, the dead wood, driftwood, letting it dry. The tendency I have sometimes is to get in here and let this dry, and then getting in with the... I will have to say that I've gotten to the point that I prefer power tools on developing the dead wood on these trees. Okay, so we've got trunk-wise, I think we've got five trunks on there that I've tried to get in and develop. And again, letting you look at what I'm calling the front of the tree, and you can see into the tree. The exact location in front, I don't have a chopstick in front of me, but the exact location probably feel is going to be over in here. That creates a problem, and that problem is created because I want to bring this branch over this way. And I know what I did is I got some nails, but I didn't get a little hammer. You know where the hammer is down there, Ed? I didn't introduce, this is Ed Coburn. He's coming along here. Ed is there. I've got Manny sitting back here who wants to go to Japan. And I have the special guest of the day, and we're very pleased to have Young Chell with us. And then on the camera, Connor Bauer, making sure everything is running. If you don't see anything, we can blame it all on Connor. I want to develop this branch and pull this branch over this way, and I'm going to put a guide wire on it. That's it.
Robert from Colorado says, greetings.
Greetings. Okay. I'm going to take the... Oops. This is what happens when you, as I said, I'm going to put some gloves on because that may stop the bleeding. it may also stop me from having some of the blood things here. And people want to know, why have I started wearing a shirt all the time when I work on trees? And I don't make any excuses right now, I guess. Okay, coming on over in here, I want to pull this branch over this way and down a little bit so we can see in here. And I'm going to use a guide wire on this branch to pull it over to pull it tight. I want to be able to, as much as possible, to see all the trunks from the front of the tree. And then use the, and I think you maybe realize already that a lot of this was pre-wired. As I said, the beauty of pre-wiring is the fact that I've been able to get some of this work done in here. I see some breaks on some of the branches here. Take this space back in here, take this branch, has a little bit of wire on it, and for those who are saying what kind of wire am I using, I am using aluminum wire. Preferably I should probably have copper, but I also find that, I don't mean to keep talking about age, but it makes it much easier to put on than some of the copper, and somebody will prove me wrong, but that's all right. Well, we can see into the tree. We can see that development, and see the trunks of the tree. A little bit long back in here. Want to see about shortening that. And I've got a branch here and a branch here that I would like to pull in a little bit closer. This one has been pulled out of the way here, as I said, you can see in. And then I'm going to take this, and I'm going to pull this up into this location up into here. I'm going to put some wire on this to help hold it up in here. And so this pulls a little bit close, and I've got another branch back in through here that can come up or maybe stay down into there. But I'm going to take this, and I'm going to put a little copper wire as a guide on that. And come around to the front again to show you from the front that this branch is going to come up in through here, and then we'll have some of these small secondaries coming across it. Well, I thought I had a lot of copper wire here.
Gary Nelson says hello.
Okay.
How's it going, Gary?
Branch back in here is also going to be shortened with the idea of a little bit of a gin on the end of it. As I say, I can always take it off as I'm developing very thin copper. Thank you, Manny. And we have coming along in there. Thank you, sir. Building behind me here is our studio. When I first moved here, if I start giving dates out, somebody's gonna say, wow. I moved here in 1970 and have been playing with this little subject even before that, and having a ball doing it. Good time, great time. Taking this branch, as I said, I want to pull this over. Have I left? I do. I have a little bit of a hole up in here where I can take copper wire and go through the branch. Through the wire anyway. Not pulling on it.
Hey, have a hello from Mark Maher.
Okay.
So you're just going to pull those two together?
I want to just pull this up, yeah, to fill in that space.
Okay.
Maybe not as much as I wanted to, because as I said, I have the front over here, and I want to have it as a secondary trunk coming back up into there and then filling in. I can't put it on there because it'll start pulling. I'm wrapping this right around here. That doesn't mean it's going to stay like this, but I've got it holding there. I'm going to come around to the front of the tree here and look at that. Am I happy with it? Coming a little bit forward. I think it'll work all right in there. It won't work all right in there.
So those bottom branches you cut off, are those all going to be a gin?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
That's what I'm planning on. And okay. Some of the other branches also. Now, there's an awful lot of foliage. As I said, this has been deer browsed. So people want to know about cutting these things back, and the deer can really browse them quite hard. So you see there's a lot of small secondary growth growing out from along the trunk. That has a tendency to make the tree fuller. And eventually we'll start thinking about taking off some of this growth. And I'm again looking at the back in here. I've got a branch back at this point. And should I pull that up? I'm not sure I want that to close in on this, but it could come up in here and fill in a little bit of the area back here. Again, this is a branch. This is not a... trunk off of the base here. So we only have the 1, 2, 3, maybe 4 branches coming off of the trunk. But if I pull this on up into there, filling that space with this particular branch. And it couldn't come off. It could, but I also want something to fill in some of these spaces. We see the space that's right in here, and just bring this over a wee bit to fill that area in there. Let me come around and turn it over here. That does exactly what I wanted to do. It's going to give me a little bit of depth in here. So this branch in here will give us some depth that we can see basically right in here. Then from here on out, what we're going to have to do, or what I'm going to have to do, is take some of the little branches to start filling in the little branches. And again, yes, I did a good bit of pre-wiring. And my only reasoning in some respect for pre-wiring like this is just because of time restraint. I have no idea what time it is, and Connor and I did not make any kind of gestures as to how far we're along we are or how much we
have. Looks like we're about 20 minutes in.
20 minutes in, okay.
Yeah, just about 18 if you want to get real specific. Plenty of time.
Actually, it's my privilege to be with this group. I am not a great computer person. Or an electronics person. consequently, I've not spent any time really online with the group as to, you know, I'm just looking at I've done something that I didn't want to do that way, but that's okay. This will work out very well.
So what style of tree are you going for?
This is what I refer to as a turtle, turtleback, having trunks coming off of one common root system. Some people will call it a clump style, and certainly I can refer to it as a clump style. But it, they're all connected, they're all part of the tree. Back in here, I have my major tree, which could see the trunks coming up like this. And somebody's going to say, well, I never saw a tree like that. Have you ever hiked the rim of the Grand Canyon? Hiking the rim of the Grand Canyon are just some marvelous, marvelous, marvelous trees. This is not a tree that's going through the torches of hell. It's just a tree that's growing in an area where it's had some adversity. And as I go along and as I start doing some carving on there, you'll see what that adversity's been like. And since we're able to, or since I've got some of the people here who say I'm able to, we'll take this and say, okay, the tree's not finished today, but on Facebook I can start putting pictures up of this particular tree. Say, here's how the tree is progressing over the years, or how it's progressing as I have some time to slowly work on the tree. Okay, so there we are. It's opened up a little bit, and I'm not saying that the branches are all going to be kept here, but I can take some of these branches and I can start pulling, as I say, to pre-wire to get the tree to grow the way I want it to grow. The branch structure where you want it is here. Nothing greater than sitting down at a lecture demo somewhere and watching somebody do some wiring. It's like watching grass grow. As I bend the branches just ever so slightly, you're not able to hear the cracks in here that I've been able to put. Now this, I'm just putting branches at some locations. I'm not getting in here and saying this is exactly where they have to be. This is my start. I do not like branches without movement to them. I like a little bit of movement, whether it's a juniper, whether it's a pine, whether it's a maple, whether it's an azalea.
Tony and Sergio just joined and both said hello.
Okay.
Hey, Tony and Sergio.
Now, length of branching, I'm not concerned about length of branching yet. Now I'm going to pull this side out a little bit over in here. It's going to be a rather broad, wider tree. I'm going to be able to see into the front. The apex is coming up and through here, but I have to develop the apex because this is my number one tree. That's the prominent tree, and that by all rights should be the lowest or the highest tree in the market here. So I'm pulling these trees down so you can see where they are, how they're going to be. So again, the front of the tree. Okay. Wanted to get in here and down that way. Do I want to keep this on or do I want to remove this? I have some smaller branching in here that can go back and fill in here, so I really don't need this branch at this point. I'm going to take it back in here with the idea that I'm going to do some gin to it. As I said, back in through here, these are getting a little tall, and I will have to think about this branch, this being the taller portion of the tree coming down this way, tree coming down this way, and getting some of the branches going towards the rear. Secondary branches that are on the tree. Today I'm not worried about a secondary branch. I'm not worried about these little branches that are going to grow in here. Bare space like this, this branch in down here could become, in time, a nice branch coming down over the top of this. I always have an empty space in here with some small branches can come down and fill there, or fill in there. Coming around over here, again, see that I'm able to pull the branching down. I'm having, as I said, some movement in here. Not a great percentage of movement, but just some movement. Now the ends of the branches can all be cut back to help me fill in. I said, as I'm doing this, I will come along, work the branches, develop each branch as I somewhat see fit. I have this coming out here. I don't like eye-piercing branches. I felt that I needed something coming out towards the front, but we'll cut that off short back in here. And again, maybe in time, a gin on this branch. The same with this branch up in here. How much gin do I want on the tree? How much dead wood do I want on the tree? Time will tell as I'm going along and working to develop this. In the back, there's no depth back in through here. So what I'm going to have to do is take some of these branches, this being the top of the tree in here. I don't want that. I don't need this going towards the inside. Or at least I happen to be talking away from this thing.
That's okay.
And I'm not sure whether people can hear what I'm saying. Awfully long in here, and the time that I have here is one of these will be growing. One of these little branches up here can grow and can come back over and hide this, and eventually this branch could be ginned, shotted, what have you. Apex here, branching coming out here. As I said, I'm using aluminum wire. And as I said, what has happened in the, I keep saying it, but it's my hope that the black scissors, I just had a fly, that the black scissors group will continue to do these kinds of things, having, we'll happen to have these live broadcasts, if you want to call it a broadcast, podcast, I guess it's a difference there, but have a live broadcast. It may be the wave of the future to to learn bonsai from some of the most wonderful speakers in the world. And if you look at the names of the people that are on the roster of demonstrators, you've got some really quite powerful people. And then again, there's a lot of people out there who are not here, and it's probably due to their choice. Some people just say that, well, why should I do that? But it's a learning experience. It's getting us...
Just hit a half hour.
Just hit a half an hour. Okay.
I think we can all kind of join in with you over there, and you can give your ending remarks, yeah?
I can. I can give some ending remarks. And...
we can all come back here with you.
Everybody's gonna
say
come
hello
back
to
here.
Everybody.
Everybody's gonna come back. Come on, Ed. You see the people here. Ed has been with me and around here since the 80s. Manny is relatively new on the block. He's hoping to get to Japan someday to learn all of these things.
Somebody buy him a ticket.
Connor is here by the good graces of himself and his expertise at computers, because you wouldn't be seeing this if it wasn't for Connor being on the street and on the block here. And this lady behind me here, pleasant, nice, gorgeous young lady, she is possibly the world's renowned person as far as the development of Kusumono. Kusumono being the plants. I'm trying to remember exactly how she says it. But,
all right.
Anyway, here we are. This gives you some idea of how it's going. Somebody's going to say, boy, it's woolly. It needs pulling in, it needs refinement, it needs to get rid of some of the longer things in here. I'm not crazy about this little bit down in here, but we have some smaller branch structure, some growth that can come down and help fill in here. This branch, I made the comment earlier, I said this is really going to be too tall for this location in here. We've got some, so we'll get a new apex growing up at that point. All the small little growths in here, along in here, all this growth in here is going to have to come off. This takes time, and we're not going to be able to give it that time today. And we'll let a little bit more here. I want to thank you for watching, developing some ideas of your own as to how we can do this, how it can be done a little bit better. As I said, we've got some awfully long branches towards the back here, and I really have to take time to see exactly how I'm going to do this, how I'm going to bring them down. I want the branches to come down as if the tree is had snow load on it. I talked about the Grand Canyon, some of those marvelous old junipers that are growing up there. I want to thank you for your time.
All right.
For your efforts. Thank you.
Thanks
for coming
everybody.
On. You're going to learn an awful lot more in the next X number of hours and the next number of days. My hat off to Robert for putting this together, developing this whole thing and his concept of the Black Scissors movement.
Black Scissors, huh?
Black Scissors, there we are, here we are, Black Scissors. Su Fang for his Bonsai Without Borders, which is, I think, just a marvelous little concept. There. Again, thank you.
Alrighty.
Happy third anniversary, Black
Happy
Scissors.
Happy anniversary, Black Scissors. We can't forget that, but I started at the beginning. Is it on the back?